Terrorist, oppressed, bomber, Taliban, Boko Haram. These are the thoughts that sprung in my mind when I heard the word Muslim. Hola, it's Nola. Today I'm going to be making a more serious video, and it's not really serious, but it is something that I wanted to address, which is, why am I learning about Islam? Well, as you just heard, it's pretty heavy. I remember when I was only around 11 years old, my mother made me watch a film called Not Without My Daughter. This film was about a woman from America who was married to a Muslim man and they had a child together. Her husband then suggested that they should go back to his home country just to stay and visit for a while. And they ended up staying there for longer than planned. Now, what happened in the country was something that scarred me and shaped my image of who I thought Muslims were for a very long time. In this movie, it depicts oppressed women, women that are abused, women that are held hostage, and people that are forced to live in conditions that are inhospitable because of Islam. Now, only being a kid, I actually carried this thought around with me. This is what I thought Islam is really about. This is who I thought Muslims were. The media and the society around me led me to pity, look down on, and be afraid of Muslims. I started distancing myself from the thought of Islam. I started distancing myself from the people that are associated with it. It just happened automatically. I remember that we had one Muslim girl in our primary school, and she had to wear covering as it is part of her religion. But she was teased, she was bullied, and she was really treated badly. I know that it was because of how we were raised, what we were taught, and what we thought. In my first year of university, I started to see more Muslims. The area that I was living in opened me to a whole community of them. I started to think to myself, what if people thought about me in the way I think about Muslims? I thought that that'd be really horrible. And being a black woman and knowing my country's history, I know how bad it feels to be looked down. I then thought to myself that it is not good for me to continue living my life this way. So I took it upon me to educate myself. But I wanted to take it further. I wanted to really learn about Islam. That way I could open up my heart and understanding what Islam is about, understanding Muslims, and also opening up the space for me to change my perspective on how I view them. This for me would make it easier and also would open up a space for me to love them. I want to say that just in these few months of learning really deeper about Islam, it has completely changed the way I look at Muslims and Islam. And I'm actually quite disappointed in myself that I let the world paint a picture for me. I let the world set up a narrative for me. And it wasn't a good one. It was a bad one. I never, ever in my life wish that any other person would look at any other person in the way I have looked at Islam and Muslims. I wish that people can open their hearts and open their minds into learning about other people and other societies, cultures, races. And that way, we could have more space to understand each other. And that could possibly lead to, hopefully, us loving each other. I would like to thank everybody that is watching this video if you are a subscriber. And if you have been interacting with me in the comment section, thank you so much for the kindness that you have shown me. Your kindness has helped erase an image that has been stuck in my mind for so many years. You guys have led such a beautiful example and painted such a beautiful picture for the people in your community. I am so happy to be interacting with you guys and so happy to be given the chance to learn more and change my own perspective. Thank you so much again. You guys have been amazing and I am so thankful once more to be amongst such peaceful and loving people. Mwah. Bye-bye.